find that the bigger the tomato, like a slicer or something, the easier it is for it to crack. And you know, it is what it is, but usually like a cherry tomato or a smaller tomato, they don't crack as easy. So keep that in your toolbox too. Husk tomatoes on point. Boy, these yellow banana tomatoes are looking good. Love it. I mean, these blue cream tomatoes, I mean, look, we got little babies. We got some good old cherry sized tomatoes. And then over here, we got these orange bananas over here. I mean, it's a beautiful thing. We got these husk tomatoes too, and they are my absolute favorite. Look at them all up there. I used to think that overwatering my tomatoes is why they split, but then I realized that that wasn't necessarily true, and overwatering is not the only cause for them to split, and in fact, it's not even the cause for them to split. I know, it's kind of crazy. So, you know, the ones that I have in my garden, they're not split really bad. They're just a little bit, so a lot of times when you see them, they're split, literally gaping hole inside of them. And basically, that's terrible. You know, at this point, you can eat them, but you should not preserve them if they're split, and they'll start to lose a lot of flavor. So, like I said before, is it due to overwatering? No, it is not. It has something to do with it, but it is not. And the main part is you want to know how much water you're putting into your garden. So you have to take into account, is it raining? Because if it's raining, then that's extra water going to the garden. So it's important that we, you know, you don't water at the same time it's raining, because inconsistency is what causes them to split. So I know you're thinking, what the hell do you mean inconsistency? That doesn't make any sense. I know, right? Well, it's a function of the tomato. So what the tomato is doing is, in periods of drought or dryness, it's not getting the water it needs. And as we know, our fruits and vegetables are made up a lot of water. So if you go through and you water heavily after a period of drought, what it's gonna do is it's gonna act like a sponge. And it's literally gonna soak everything up that it can. And it's trying to pump up because it's trying to go into survival mode. And so what happens then is once it soaks up as much water as it can, it's gonna keep soaking it up because it's been through a period of dryness. And then it happens, it splits. And sometimes you get a little split, and sometimes you get a big old nasty burst. And that's really the thing that kind of messes up the tomatoes, because when it bursts, it's gonna lose a lot of its flavor, and it can introduce bacteria in. Now, that being said, I still eat my split tomatoes, and I don't think it's an issue, but when it comes to canning them, like I said before, you should not be eating them. You should not be canning them when they're split really bad, because again, that's a point for bacteria to come in. And any bacteria you start canning with, you're gonna finish canning with, and it's gonna be even worse. So how can we be mindful about being consistent with watering? Well, it's pretty simple as far as, you know, when it rains, you gotta know, hey, it's raining, I'm gonna cut my sprinkler off. Maybe I need to give it a few days. Know how much rain you've gotten. Did you get a tenth of an inch? Did you get 10 inches? You know, anywhere in between. You know, we know how much our garden should be getting a week. It's roughly about 1 inch to 2 inches a week, even 3 inches, depending on how hot it is where you are. So just knowing how much rain has hit is important, because you can cut off your watering at that time. You can water more, you can water less if needed, but trying to be consistent. Now, you don't have to be right on the money, but you do need to be consistent, and that's gonna be key in helping your tomatoes stay nice and firm and flavorful for you. So today I watered these in the morning, and then we got like a tropical downpour, and I think we got about 2 inches of rain, and that's kind of an issue. So what I need to do now is manage how much water goes in for the rest of the week. And if I have to hold back on watering a little bit, I will. But that's where the mulch comes in, because it helps keep a consistent moisture on the ground. And a lot of times, a lot of people recommend putting about 4 inches of mulch onto your tomatoes. So, you know, putting that mulch down will keep the ground consistently moist, and it will help you manage your water. Another technique can be just measuring how much water you're putting in. So that can be as simple as putting out like some tuna cans or something to measure how much water your sprinklers are hitting, or measuring how much water your hose is outputting if you're hand watering, just anything like that. And a rain gauge definitely helps too. What I do is I just set buckets out and then I get a good estimate. So any of those things can help you, but knowing how much water goes in will make all the difference.
Give us a like and subscribe. Check out the Backyard Gardens podcast, new episodes twice a week. And I hope that you've gotten enough to keep your tomatoes from splitting and you can stay on top of it and just be consistent with your watering and be careful and you should be good to go. So, and it's okay if you get a split tomato, we all get them. So what? Just learn from your lessons. But until next time, we'll catch you guys later. See ya.